Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
Sometimes you want to add text at a specific location on the page, but your layout won't let you. Putting the text inside a text box will give you the freedom to move it wherever you want. You can also format it using different shape styles and WordArt. To create a text box, go to the Insert tab, then click the Text Box command. There are several built-in styles to choose from, but you can always go with a plain text box and add formatting yourself. To do this, click Draw Text Box, then click, hold, and drag roughly where you want the text box to go. Now you can type whatever you want. You can even format the text using the options on the Home tab and the Format tab. In this example, I'm going to make several different changes. We'll start by selecting the edge of the text box, then aligning the text to the middle. Next, we're going to go to the Home tab and increase the font size to make it easier to read. You can also change the font itself if you want something other than the default. Finally, I'm going to align the text to the center of the text box to give it a nice, clean appearance. I'm also going to remove the paragraph spacing because that can have an effect on your vertical alignment. It helps to think of text boxes as just another type of shape in Word. That means you can easily give them a new look by changing the fill color, removing the outline, or adding an effect. Just go back to the Format tab, then look to all the options in the Shape Styles group. You can also change the shape of the text box using the Edit Shape command here. Word gives you all the usual shapes to choose from. Why don't we try a circle instead of the default square? To resize a text box, click and drag the sizing handles on the sides or the corners of the shape. To move it, just place your cursor on the edge and drag it wherever you want. Another great thing about text boxes is the fact that you can format the text inside using a special feature called WordArt. You'll find everything you need in the WordArt Styles group. You can use the commands on the right to adjust your formatting manually, including the text fill, outline, and special effects. Or you can try one of the built-in WordArt styles, also known as Quick Styles. I don't think I like the way these look with the orange background, so I'm going to leave the text the way it is. What I'd really like to do is add an effect where it says Annual Clearance. But because this is regular text, we need to convert it before we can do anything else. First, select the text you want to format, then go to the Insert tab. From here, you're able to convert the text to a regular text box, or you can convert it straight to WordArt. This has the added benefit of giving the text box a transparent background. Remember, you can customize your WordArt using the commands on the Format tab. In this example, I'm going to check out the options under Text Effects. These are pretty much the same effects that you can add to shapes in Word, including drop shadow, 3D rotation, and more. But if you look to the bottom of the menu, you'll find an extra option called Transform. This effect will actually change the shape of your text. Just mouse over the options for a preview, and be careful not to choose one that makes your text unreadable. I think this one looks pretty good. Once you've added a transform effect, the text will stretch to fit the text box anytime you resize it. You probably don't want to use WordArt in more serious documents, like a resume or an academic paper. But if you're working on something casual like this flyer, it can really be a lot of fun.